We have three inequalities here that involve absolute values. And then below them, we have potential values for x. And what I want to do in this video is see which of these potential values for x actually make the inequality true. So let's start with this first one in green here on the left. It says the absolute value of x is less than the absolute value of -7. So let's think about which of these x values would make this true. And before I even try out the x values, let's see if we can simplify this inequality. And the thing that might jump out at you, and I encourage you to try these on your own before I work through them, what might jump out at you is we know what the absolute value of -7 is. The absolute value of -7 is how far from 0 is -7? Well, it's 7 to the left. It's the distance from -7 to 0 is 7. Or another way to think about it is, the absolute value of any number is always going to be the non-negative version of it. So this right over here, absolute value of -7 is just going to be 7. So an equivalent inequality would be that the absolute value of x needs to be less than 7. So let's see if it's true for x equals -8. So if x equals -8, then wherever we see the x, we put it at -8 there. So let's see, is the absolute value of -8 less than 7? Is that true? Well, the absolute value of -8 is just going to be 8. So is 8 less than 7? No, 8's greater than 7. So that x equals -8 does not satisfy the inequality. Now x equals -2. Well, wherever we see the x, let's put a -2. So the absolute value of -2 needs to be less than 7. What's the absolute value of -2? Well, it's going to be +2. Is +2 less than 7? Sure, 2 is less than 7. So this is x equals -2 satisfies our inequality. The absolute value of -2 is going to be less than the absolute value of -7. Then finally, x equals 6. So the absolute value is the absolute value of 6. Once again, everywhere where I see the x, I just put the 6 there. If x equals 6, we're going to say the absolute value of 6, is that less than 7? Well, the absolute value of 6 is, once again, just 6. 6 is 6 to the right of 0. Is 6 less than 7? Yeah, sure. 6 is less than 7. So x equals 6 and x equals -2 both satisfy the inequality. Now let's do this one here in this magenta color. And once again, encourage you to pause the video and try to work through it out on your own. So let's try x equals -4. So if x equals -4, we're going to say the absolute value of -4 greater than 5. Absolute value of -4, well, that's just going to be 4. Is 4 greater than 5? No, 4 is less than 5. So that doesn't work. Now x equals 3. Everywhere we see the x, replace that with a 3. The absolute value of 3, is that greater than 5? Absolute value of 3 is just 3. So is 3 greater than 5? No, 3 is less than 5. I think you're seeing, hopefully you're getting the hang of it. So finally, if x equals -9, the absolute value of -9, that would need to be greater than 5. Absolute value of -9, well, that's just going to be +9. So it's just going to be 9. And is that greater than 5? Well, sure, 9 is greater than 5. So x equals -9 satisfies the inequality. All right, now let's do these ones in this, I guess, this light purple color. The absolute value of x needs to be greater than -16. So there's something very interesting about this one. We don't even have to look at the choices here. Can you think of any x for which this would not be true? Well, just think about it a little bit. The absolute value of a number, is it ever going to be negative? No, the absolute value of a number is going to be 0 or positive. It's going to be non-negative. So this right over here is 0 or positive, or we could call that non-negative. 0 or positive. So if this thing over here is 0 or positive, something that is 0 or greater, something that is 0 or positive, is always going to be greater than a negative number. So this is actually true for all x's. We don't even have to try them out. We can try them out. Actually, we will try them out just so you see that. But this is going to be true for all x's because when you take the absolute value, if x is 0, it's going to be 0. But for any other value, any non-zero value of x, the absolute value of it is going to be positive. And let's just see that. We could put any x there, and this statement's going to be true. Absolute value of x equals -15? Well, the absolute value of -15 Is that greater than negative 16? Well, the absolute value of negative 15 is positive 15. And of course, positive 15 is going to be greater than negative 16. A positive is always going to be greater than a negative. So this is true. If x equals 3, absolute value of 3, is that greater than negative 16? Oh, whoops, let me write it that way. Absolute value of 3, is that greater than negative 16? Sure, absolute value of 3 is 3. And 3 is positive, so it's going to be greater than a negative number. So that works. And as I said, any x would work there. And then finally, if x equals 9, well, absolute value of 9, if x equals 9, is that greater than negative 16? Well, sure, that's just 9. And that is greater than negative 16. Even if x was 0, then you would have 0 greater than negative 16, which is absolutely true. So any x here works.